It happens to all of us. You're on the road and steer clear of that smoke billowing jalopy that looks unsafe. That's just smart, but what if I told you the cars that look fine may in fact be dangerous?
We looked at 600 different cars from a variety of different sellers and found that 227 of them had open recalls that hadn't been addressed.
Consumer's Checkbook executive editor Kevin Brassler is running down the results of their investigation. Let's start by defining the problem. Used cars can be sold with open recalls.
A dealership, a car lot, they can sell you a car with a known safety defect that's been recalled and not have to fix it first and not even have to warn you about it in the vast majority of states.
And yeah, some recalls can be for minor things like typos in the printed materials, but they can be for big problems too.
Our investigation found safety defects where door latches may not work, so your doors might open when they shouldn't. If you're in an accident, seat belts might not work, your airbag might not deploy, and if it does, it may injure or kill you, and braking systems that don't work. I mean, these aren't misprints and owner's manuals. These aren't minor problems. These are things that most people, when they're buying a car, would want to know that that defect exists and it wasn't fixed.
These required fixes keep more than just the driver of that vehicle safe.
Safe for other passengers, our family, and safe for other people who are driving all around us. I mean, the fact is there are just way too many cars with unaddressed safety defects. As many as 1 in 4, 1 in 5 cars on the road have a problem, and many of those problems are life-threatening.
Okay, this is all very shocking, but let's get to what you can do about it, like who's safer to buy from. There are some recall compliance laws on the books.
Rental car companies that often sell cars have to have these problems addressed before they resell their cars. And there's a requirement that the General Services Administration, the federal government itself, has to have these problems addressed before it can sell cars.
So recalls on cars sold by government agencies or car rental companies should be addressed. And one private seller also stands out.
Carvana actually did a pretty good job of warning its buyers. There's an open recall here. This is what the problem is. This is how you get a repair done. But Carvana's not exactly taking the next step in getting that repair done itself. They're leaving it up to their customers.
The final piece of advice, before you buy any used car, check for open recalls yourself. The National Highway Transportation Safety Administration has made it easy.
The NHTSA has set up a website where you can just plug in any VIN number of any vehicle, and it will tell you whether or not there's a recall that hasn't been addressed.
On most cars, you can view the vehicle identification number through the windshield. It's facing outward from the front of the dashboard on the driver's side.
Check that website to make sure that there isn't an open recall. And if there is one, tell the seller you're not interested in buying that vehicle until they have it fixed. If they're not willing to do that, then buy something else.
Avoiding used cars with known safety defects is at the top of the list.